dead. Shatter gets dropped in. That's going to be both supports now on the ground. Don't manage to find the kills, though. It's going to be auto traded out. Gives the ult for his life.
You know what? I have. I gave her several chances already. So either she shows up or she doesn't. I'm not going to reload. She gets deep neck. It's going to fall.
It's going to be a full reset again here for the side of
the game. Shows up, she shows up. And while Marvel's looking for a shadow, they lose profit. Adamo, I think. I'm not going to worry about it.
You're down two. You're trying to make the shadow happen. Mono lands his spike. Photon barriers in play and catches Adamo in creative right. Careful of double fusion, slowly pulling them through. Alarm getting a couple frags in there. 65% counting. This could be big. Plus catches everybody.
Yeah, sound barrier going to be used by Namo just to try to stay alive through it. Shatter gets dropped in, only finds Shockwave, but Bunny Astro's got a beat of his own to go ahead and turn this one around. Getting on top of Fitz, they find the elimination. The Blizzard damage will just tick away at Marvel. Gets the kill. 2U with a sliver of HP will be shown a bit of mercy as Bunny Astro finishes him off, but a team kill at 84%. Yep. The respawn's still coming through. Dynasty might just get completely shut out of Busan.
It's looking like an alarm's going to set up for a window here as well. Mano's going to be there to fire strike, and somebody's going to get sniped out of this too. You better have that Matrix ready to go. TP across. You'll be able to touch at least.
Cap starting to come through. Likely just going to be surrendered over for a brief moment. Immortality field eliminated. Shockwave finds creative on the back end. That's moments before he would have the Animatrix available. Bunny Astro finds profit. Oh, you can tell he is very much in his element right now. Moving back over onto the Lucio. To you dead, the self-destruct won't find anything, and with Vince gone, that'll be the flip and that'll be the OT starting to bleed away. Anamo and Creative are both alive, but they cannot get the touch. The OT bleeds down 8% in the first round, 7% in the second. The Philadelphia Fusion very much warmed up after their first series versus the Hangzhou Spark, absolutely demolished the Seoul Dynasty in the first map.
215, the overall scoreline there. Smile on Mano's face, a sign of things to come, maybe. Hold that one with bated breath, though, because we still have plenty of maps still coming through in Seoul. Okay, I think they might be looking for some changes in the next map. Wouldn't surprise me if Jesha comes back in, assuming Seoul want to play a bit more dive, maybe some Winston stuff as well. Initial map not going their way at all. Even in the mirror, double blizzards coming down, super sound barriers coming down as well. Carpet gets a better profit. The battle of these two veterans, two of the most veteran players, I think, in the entire league, and Carpet wins round number one.
That he does in fairly convincing fashion. I mean, Profit just pretty much non-existent, it felt like, at every twist and turn throughout there, just getting picked off. I mean, when you have a Lucio getting on top of your Mei and he's finding the elimination, that is not a good look. But Dynasty going to be looking to keep their spirits high. You see some wry smiles still on their faces. They now have map pick in their hands, and we'll see where they want to take us when we come back from the break.
The Overwatch League is brought to you by Teams.
I'll do what I can.
The official voice supplier of the Overwatch League.
Officer, I'm a gentleman.
My liege,
official refreshment of the Overwatch League.
Alright, we are back and just one map into this series, the final series here, the APAC region for the playoffs. This one deciding representative from the APAC region, Fusion, very convincingly have started this off with a win on Busan. I mean, what do you say, 200-15 is the end percentage scores there from those two rounds that were played. Dynasty just not finding any legs to stand on whatsoever. And yet again, the Fusion, they're keeping up with the musical chairs. We're going to see another substitution as QO subs in for Shockwave.
This is going to be, you know, in some ways pretty similar to what we saw from our last matchup, and definitely in terms of substitutions. Expect a lot more of these musical chairs to come through where EQO is going to play now, maybe next map. Carby gets sent out for Shockwave, and Shockwave and EQO together. Maybe it's map dependent, so it will, you know, we'll see what maps we get from this.
Gentlemen! Mount up!
So I might want to be at least a little bit worried here. I have faith that Sol will make a bit of a bounce back. This should be a pretty close series. Absolutely not a 3-0. Look, if it's a 3-0, then I guess one team very, very much drops their spaghetti ball. We answer that question quite quickly if there's going to be a 3-0, but there's a lot of spaghetti to have. Hungry, second, don't worry, you can come back for seconds. A lot of maps to play.
Yeah, this is like a, when you go to like a family style Italian restaurant, they just bring out the spaghetti, and it's just this massive, massive bowl of spaghetti that feeds like 10 people. But yeah, hopefully we've got plenty to munch on here. And I mean, for Fusion fans, yeah, maybe you can see a little bit of a sigh of relief here. You start off series 1-0. For the veteran viewers on the side of the Fusion, I think they might be sweating because they remember that reverse sweep. So even when you're ahead, you might still be behind. We'll have to just wait and see, though. But they absolutely are firing on all cylinders. You can see that their spirits are very much through the roof right now. For the side of the Dynasty, it's quiet contemplation and preparation as they will be taking us to Hanamura for Assault.
Uh-huh. And this is a map that neither doesn't really favor either side, I don't think. I mean, both teams are very comfortable playing the Brawl. And Hanamura being the map here, I don't think there was a Sunrise, so Marvel's still in. That means more Rhyme. And again, comfortable position for both teams to play through. HQO being added to the mix. Option song for them. Echo's back available now as well. Strangely, I don't think we've really seen an Echo play in our last matchup and over the course of all our previous matches. Now EQO's thinking about it. It's possible. In fact, it is going to be one of the defense here with Funny Ash. The only person that really is going to be dealing EQO now. Can actually nano hop by Sigma here, so there's a couple options, but EQO should be the one receiving most of the moves.
Alrighty, well, things around just a little bit. Profit moves over to the main for just a second at least. We'll see if they want to stick through with it. Scout forward.
Oh,
get a read, and there's the Symmetra.
There, yeah, that's what I'm thinking. You really want the Sim here to TP across. Hanamura attack on A, very, very favors the play. So here we go. They're not going to go across the map, just up to the left side, get the rotation, and now they have the entire left flank of the cap.
They're trying to give him a little bit of a run around here. See if they can try to force Mono's position and get him to set up somewhere else. Wall's decent. They can't get that kill, though, but they do force him off, and now they're ticking up. It's really difficult to reconnect.
Best give up
this.
Now!
Well, a good wall defense, but he gets topped up yet by another good wall. This time, Mono cannot escape. Everybody piles in on top of the Orisa. They find that elimination. EQO going to be dead on arrivals. He drops down to try to contest. Second tick now going to be snatched up, and it seems like that should just be the end. Very nicely done here from the side of the Soul Dynasty. A great reply as Anamo going to be realistically the only casualty. He's not going to be split spawned either. He can join in fairly fastly, though, either way.
What a good play from Soul Dynasty as well. I mean, they just read that situation perfectly. They look at the lineup from Philadelphia Fusion, see that it's going to be quite prone to a Symmetra TP play. Obviously, they're not going to TP to the point because it can get destroyed, so they go for a top there.
Are you cold, human insect? It's
suddenly they have all the position they need for this cop.
Momentum, a function of mass and velocity.
Can trade it out. Matrix not going to be quite too much value. No one realistically able to play around it. And EQO says, oh, look at this. All right, Reinhardt, right in front of me. Thanks for teleporting directly.
My sword is mighty.
Gets that elimination. Looks for a little bit of extra charge there as Hoppe will reset and go again.
Okay, maybe I undersold how big the six-man bone is. It, obviously, it's huge, but my perspective... Well, my perspective was I saw could just back out of it. So that's why, initially, I was looking at the six-man bone, like, alright, well, they could just chill for a little bit. Just wait for the shield up from Marvel. Don't commit into it. Wait for the bone to go away. Another
wall.
Prophet's been landing these time and time again.
Another Bionid goes out, this time hits three, Prophet dead to it. Both tanks gonna be slowed up. So that's the Blizzard, they find some picks, but they cannot get on the
point. Truly, who made it Prophet's yours?
We caught the mother, Taskmaster.
That's a good idea though, because these walls have given Sol so many opening plays, and is really key to why I think making Sim Brawl TC composition work. We've got the Photon Barriers out now, but who are they gonna focus on? Sound Barrier as well.
Oh, the halt and the flux is going to be juicy, and the shields are now expiring. Immortality Field will greet them as they hit the ground, but so will a hell of a lot of death. Shadow's going to be dropped in. It finds one or two, and they cannot get any kills off the back end of it. Now it's going to be time for a bit of swap out here, I think. For the rest of the side of the dynasty, Fitz likely to change. They just get stomped out of existence.
Jail! Where are they going to go towards? Okay, yeah, it is going to be interesting. I'm thinking that because I see creatives. This window available for the next fight. Fitz is over towards the gas. The tank that makes the most sense here is the Orisa, but you're now into a kind of Orisa mirror. The fact that Mano's playing one as well. Carpi's already been on the Ash. He's got the damage boost from Funny Asher as well. Actually, Funny Asher drops off towards the brig. So I actually kind of prefer the Mercy there. Anyway, this is not necessarily a good move for the Sol Dynasty, because I think their Brawl has a little bit more A, staying power, and B, engage power, especially with both speed boost and a TP.
Oh, Fitz is going to die immediately. The ambitious is used by creative. Self-destruct to you, only going to find EQO. Arbatus is going to hound down Prophet, but won't get the opportunity. Hotbox there gets the finishing.
Long live acceptance.
All of these initiations just in the blink of an eye.
Thank you on the Genji here as well, which is supported by Alarm on Anna, which means a possible Nano play in the future. First of all, gives Alarm a very good nano target, even though I think your Echo was a pretty decent nano target, rather. But now they can just sort of dive through, cleave the entire team on their approach. A lot of teams, especially on this Orisa, you have to play this top right stairs. You're playing the Sim, now Sol Dynasty, they're caught, they're stuck having to make this play happen time and time again. Just attempt to make this play happen.
Okay, well, they're looking to isolate bottom. Seems like they break the wall down fast enough. Nana moves out of the EQO, and now he's got the blade ready to go. Does that patiently, though. He doesn't want to over-aggress and overstep. Keeps himself played back with the rest of the team, just poking and prodding. Waiting for the next setup, and Corbin just don't advance. The final fight. Still going to be the Camp Matrix utilized by creative, but he's going to fall. Mono gets him with the headshots. The blood takes him also very low, and now EQO is around the back line, dashes straight up. And they are just wiping the floor with the Sol Dynasty right now. The Fusion looking fantastic on this point B defense.
And the thing is, you go back to the notion of like, well, how do they actually engage here? Because in this Orisa mirror, which now it's going to be a double shield mirror with Hopper and Chiyu both on these Sigmas, right? You have to have Sol set up a firing line on some part of the map on B, most likely top right side, right? They're not going to be able to go left unless they change over towards A Sim again. Can they go main? Well, they don't have high ground control. So they must go top right, but wait up this fire nade. So Alarm's been hitting these time and time again. It's a little hard for 2U to stop them when you're not in a D.Va, I suppose. But this time, at least, Sol Dynasty are not just going to lose all their lives, so they can be patient. And the same thing will repeat itself, because this time when Sol try and make this top right play, EQ's got the blade, and they're going to nano blade into it, and it's going to be really, really good.
I was going to say, you might want to rally right now, and I'm almost going to pop that for a hold off the high ground.
I'll do what I can.
Carpet just pushing back. Yeah, they've got a nice little bunker set up on the high ground.
It's running
doesn't
out.
Really get them closer to the actual point. Blade now comes in. He's added up. Prophet could be the first one to fall to the game. And overall, Dragonblade, it doesn't find any kills, but it forces the Dynasty completely back out of the building.
So not the biggest Dragonblade, but at the same time, like you said, in terms of positioning, solar reset here. They've lost all pressing to make a move up. The rally is gone, but they have their ultimates coming online. So maybe there's a window of opportunity, especially with creative's actual window coming online. They basically have to just use all these ultimates just to get this high ground control, bob the point, have some pressure elsewhere on the map. There it is.
Yeah, they get the bomb onto the point. They're looking for the hole to actually pull them onto the low ground. Don't manage to make that work. Mortality field going to be used. That expires. Bob out. QO gonna die. Another Bob just gonna be situated behind the wall. Blizzard at the ready. It's gonna be Prophet lobbing it in the corner over towards the spawn room. Creative gonna fall the immortality field. I guess he wasn't on it. It's killed off after he's already fallen. Prophet now gonna be eliminated. Does manage to find Alarm from beyond the grave, but it looks like a tick. It's so just gonna be a far cry hope here from the side of Soul Dynasty. The Philadelphia Fusion put their foot down on point B, and they do not allow any percentage gain.
And again, I shake my head a little bit at this as well, as I'm sure Soul Dynasty is shaking their fist. And I see so little opportunity for Soul Dynasty to actually make an engage here. In fact, by the fact that they put Prophet back on the main. They start with Prophet on towards the Trace, and then they realize this doesn't give us an opening. What was giving an opening was this main, great ice walls, locking out Mano, giving you the opportunity to get these kills. But then you've kind of off the
close ranks!
This kind of rock, paper, scissors, comp matchup that's great to double shield is actually the Brawl. You do see that a lot when teams want to take down a shield comp. You see the Brawl come on through, they get the engage, and Orisa just can't do anything. She sits there and she cannot count. She really can't hold up and hold her own ground versus Brawl. She kind of gets run over. That's kind of the weakness of playing that double shield, right? For Sol to give that up, to then attempt to slowly move over to the double shield cup. They started with single shield, then they went to the double shield. The Prophet was even on Tracer for a long duration of time as well. It was quite surprising that Sol wanted to try and get B in that fashion. My opinion here is that Orisa's hard to attack with, especially up against a team that is defensively playing Orisa and has far better angles than you, at least to start with. And how many times
more
who's a player on
your shield,
so they just like somebody. It just happens almost every single play. So I think Sol should have just played more, and they're back in the ball.
They are on the top. Go ahead, get the scouting report, and look to swap it up.
Discipline shall bring us victory.
Thinking back, I think this
best give up now.
I think he actually came on Mora. Beginning of his career with the Genji pick. So, targeting back to an age long since past, but to you, well, starts things off on the right foot, but instantly they will lose fits. So hit scan for hit scan, gonna be traded out. Wall goes up, looking to cut off the auto, manages to make his way up on top of it. You now diving into the back, wants to get rid of EQO. Got the May. Oh,
need
the
help,
he makes it just over the other side of the wall. He's still gonna be in the fight, and now Marvel doesn't have any peel. The D-Matrix is not there to try to
peel my cure out.
Probably finds the Astro. They want to hold on to this point A defense.
What's Sol doing? They just gave him Marvel's life for no reason. That he's trying to hold the front line, and you're the Zhryan, and you're looking like, where's
Tony? What can I do?
Where's my D.Va? Why am I not getting any help? Because Fusion's gonna chase EQO for some reason. And now they got a D.Va here as well. Two ticks have gone through.
There's nothing to just mitigate this damage. It's gonna be coming out from our base. Gives a nice little wave. His Brock is popped out. Manages to make his way out to safety. Marvel will find Alarm with the fire. He's charging up the shatter. Drops it down. EQO's gonna fall. Prophet set up for just a moment by that explosion. He manages to stay alive, and he nearly has a Blizzard online. It's 98.1%. Funny Astro gonna be taken down. Cartman tries to stay alive. He can't manage to make it happen. And Hoppe will drop off the side of the map.
Oh my god.
And by with an absolute miracle, the Soul Dynasty will hold on to point A.
And I think it starts with the fact that there was that amplification matrix from Creative. Marvel in, swinging his hammer around, finds a shatter. Even if it's only gone to one, they secure that kill as well. Soul Dynasty have the staying power. They didn't even need to then use the sound barrier. So good recovery, but it was looking very messy. I mean, look at that 98.1%. That was nearly a cap for the
what has that witch done?
A blisteringly fast double cap or anything like that for the Fusion. They would love to hold on to some ults, but they lost the hero again at the beginning.
Yeah, I'm just going to have to wait and try to maybe reset, but no, they decide to go in with the Flux. That's going to force out the sound barrier. Mortality as well can be used. Drop before he dies. Will get the Blizzard off. Nice accretion hit from Hoppe, though, to get the finishing blow and stop any further follow-up. But you can see everybody else pushing forward well beyond the choke point. Looking to find some extra staggers so they have more time for Prophet and Marvel to rejoin the fight.
And now you have a play for EQO, but I'm not too sure what the mileage on this play is going to be, because you don't have a nano to support it. You're not playing a dive composition, so EQO is going to end up diving in pretty much by himself. It's a
the king and country!
I hadn't spoken about it just yet, but now's the perfect time. This has to work for them. I don't know how much it will. Amplification Matrix comes on through.
Wall going to be used. Deadeye is out. Prophet will find Hotbuff. Flaps it Sigma, we're going to have to wait for a reset. No, I don't like it again, but now EQO, he draws the blade. Alarm is going to be gone. Funny Astro dead, so EQO is just going to be sitting here, blade in hand, nothing else to do. He will take Crawford down with him, but it's just a matter of time. The final punch will get rid of the Genji. We're expecting to see maybe another last-minute swap here for EQO, perhaps, but 38 seconds remaining, starting from two ticks. They need to get this cap.
They'll go over towards Echo now. I mean, fire would have been an option, but you don't have time for. Do you really want to swap Funny Astro off now? You probably should have played the fire to start with. That's kind of what you have to think about. But Echo's going to be the next best option without changing anything else. No ultimate online for Soul just yet. There's maybe a window gear. We'll have to drop that through.
You want a piece of Roman and Spoofy? Well,
Kuro finds the opening pick and gives his life for it. Nano finishes him off with that right click. Boom. What's going to be used? Spins up into the air, drops him back down. Sliver of HP remaining here on the Cowboy. He rolls forward, trying to get up into Hapa's face. Meanwhile, back on the point, the contention is coming through. Hapa kills himself. Ulf, actually, his primary fire eliminates him. Mono and Funny Astro now going to fall. The Blizzard buying time. Marvel rolls back in, manages to find two. That is a team kill. That's EOG bleeding away, and that is a tie.
I never swung.
The Dynasty close out a 4-hole on point A.
That is exactly both teams debating their fan base as well. Soul looking disappointing on their attack for that B phase. Fusion looking absolutely dominant.
I demand satisfaction! Now!
2-0, I think Fusion got this. They got in the bag. We have this match point here. We're
down with a near!
And then that A. Fusion cannot get a loose. One! And Soul clutched up. It was that one clutch fight at Kilios when they came back in. Creative drops that application matrix, Marvel gets a solar shatter, but it's enough. And after that moment, Fusion could then never again get a foothold on. Blade was always going to be pretty bad considering the matchup. The Echo comes in far too late, and Fusion don't have the resources.
Unbelievable recovery from the Dynasty. They persevere, they manage to hold on to the point the whole way through. They tie us up 1-1. It's going to be map picked now for the side of Philadelphia Fusion. We'll see where they decide to take us for hide when we come back from the break.
The North, Temeria.
Long live the King!
The Overwatch League is brought to you by TeamSpeak, the official voice supplier of the Overwatch League.
Another replaces him.
I pass on every 10th round.
Long live, etc., etc.
Coca-Cola is the official refreshment of the Overwatch League.
All right, we are back, and we are all tied up 1-1. Busan going the way of the Philadelphia Fusion, but Seoul Dynasty pick up a win on their map pick of Hanamura. An incredible first hold there at point A against the Philadelphia Fusion. Just nuts play from the side of the Seoul Dynasty at the end. Fitz clutching it up. There's just some wonderful stuff happening there. So if you just tuned in, whew, you might have missed potentially the best map, or at least the best round that we'll have in this entire series, but I hope that is not a correct statement. Hopefully they've got more of that for us here today, because now we're going to get ready to go into Nimbani, the map pick for Hybrid from the side of the Fusion.
I got to say as well, now looking at Hanamura, I think Busan was just a starter. That wasn't the real spaghetti ball just yet. That was like,
get
your breadsticks out there. No, I'm not talking about the Vancouver Titans. I'm just talking about what we're just warming up with. The pasta, the spaghetti still being served. Still
it's
in the
an
kitchen,
order,
kitchen,
you know?
Still cooking. Yes, it arrived. Big time.
Remove his cowards, then his ears.
Right rank where your off tank just flies away. You're like, oh, can I get some help? And off flies. It like walks out of the mortality field as well. And then you have that where, like, it looks like you should win, but then they drop spaghetti to it. The Soul come in and Marvel gets two kills, and I went back and watched, it was a 5v6, because two you got DMAC'd at the start of that fight, and still Soul won that. So goodness, did the spaghetti arrive big time. Like, it all came all at once.
I mean, it was basically that entire fight was decided by the
We actually have not had a single substitution. And Fusion in our previous matchup was substituting like every single map. I personally expected Soul to maybe look over towards Gesture at some point, but
we had the one foot for Fusion, you know, bringing EQO in.
Yeah, but for this map, they've stayed the course.
Yes.
So, and so has Soul, and Soul are potentially even looking to play Marvel in the Winston. So I guess, you know, Gesture's not going to play at all. So anyone looking for the playoff Soul version where Gesture comes out of the Roadhog, nope, not gonna happen. You're probably a good thing that he doesn't come out of the Roadhog. I know Roadhog got buffed, but not buffed enough that he'll see game time. So Soul Dynasty will be looking towards possibly
your spear.
Five, obviously the scout. Soul can definitely match this. Brawl might not be the best option. We'll see how they go.
Just checking things out. Marvel rolls all the way on point before seeing a single Soul. We'll go back and let's
his
see
team
what the swap up's going to be. Yeah, Winston. Okay. Yes. It's an unintentional pun.
Okay,
here we go with this again.
It's got Prophet on the top. Okay.
Yep.
So they have opted for like the most, one of the more hardcore anti-dive combos. Whenever she's tall, by the way, it's definitely quite a bit of an anti-dive. You got the double stuns coming from Fitz and Animo here as well. The mortality for
long live.
They still have to push. The problem with this anti-dive is you still have to be in position to set yourself up on the high ground before your comp can really come online.
Carpe sticking around from the back. Topped up, so flank angle covered for the most part. Continue to keep pressure and keep eyes on the enemy tracer. Some poking though, but Alarm going to fall.
I pass on every 10.
Is that
going
to be enough for them to get themselves onto the point? Right now, it is. We'll be given at least a tick. Waiting for Ceiling to come back in. It's the slow slide of despair. Anomal sends Astro off the side, and he just cannot get back on the point. He cannot get back on the side. Huge pickup there from Tuckers Old Dynasty, and that is going to help net them this first lockdown here on point A. Nearly 5 minutes of the time bank. Absolutely massive for the Dynasty.
That's a funny Astro death off the side there is exactly what every single Philadelphia Fusion fan felt on Hanamura as they slowly...
As their
hopes and dreams, they realized they weren't going to win Hanamura, but maybe a bit of a reset here. Hopper going over towards Sigma. Things can change, okay? All Sigma is a legit cop. Carby over towards the Hanzo, obviously to try and counter Marvel. And guess what? Probably
Sigma.
Difference here will also be the fact that Creative has the Animatrix available, so expect a lot of damage fits and proper with this game.
Some football action inside the Fusion. Recon. It's the word that everybody's piled indoors. Mono taking just a little bit of damage there, smattering of it from those storm arrows. Oh, EQO, he's right up in front of it, and that is a huge EMP. Five-man hack, looking for the kills now, though. Fitz gonna be falling low. T2 is gonna be knocked out of the mech by the minefield. He'll get finished off by Alarm. Fitz falling to the
Long side. Live the King!
Rally's rolling from Anamo, but is that gonna be an overstep from him? He's completely surrounded. He will get cut down. Profits will be able to find one. As Carpe finds multiple in the fight. Cleanup is gonna be good. That's gonna be cart control now. Rested away from the Dynasty.
Double support ultimately needed to be spent by the Philadelphia Fusion. They were very difficult to track them, but for good reason, they don't want to get B cap. They don't want to make. They don't want to have some Dynasty carried through the seat. Now, look over towards only Dragon Strike being the available option here. Not the highest value. What they did do is prevent the window from creative from fighting Valley. EQO hit one of the bigger EMPs that we've seen today. So now, as Fusion are waiting for more ultimates to come through, they have to look for counter trace here. Where's the Dragon from Carpe?
Dragon from Profit, decent, gets some damage in. Now it's going to be a self-destruct over the top from 2U. There's it right at main, and that zones
so
him back
late,
enough
man.
For the cart to actually slide into point B. Power driver from Mono will find creative, but he's
though
not
trees
really
live longer
much.
Than food, they need protection.
Spawn now. Cleanup is going to be good as Fitz loses shots. Still 4 minutes strong on the timing for the final stretch. Soul Dynasty looking alive.
And now, you know, Fusion, okay, we'll play the same if you want to play some shield stuff, we'll go double shield here. We're going to dig our heels in even further than that. And Carpet Strikes, you got to play that early. When Profit strikes, you have to counter Dragon Strike almost immediately. The alarm down here is all that is deadly. Arrow through the window, I think.
Either way, it was a headshot, so it would have been dead all the same. As Profit just plays around the flank, looking to get some more arrows in. He has yet another Dragon Strike available. Arrow to scout the right side. Spam shots not really connecting, but as
oh
I say
God.
It, oh, he finds EQO. I think EQO might have actually been in stealth as well. He's just exiting the spawn room. Dragon Strike will cut off Mono, and he can't try to pull back, but he actually needs to play forward all the same because he needs to continue contesting the card. He's the only one realistically that can stay situated right there.
No
at the moment, Fitz gets through his face. Flashbang in, they ban the hammer. The EMP only finds one as Fitz will find two on the back end of the fight, and they will glide into the box of victory with 3 minutes and 3 seconds remaining.
That is the god arrow from Brock. That headshot onto EQO secures them the entire fight and the point. Just that one arrow. Get rid of the Sombra, there's no more EMP. That was what Fusion were holding all their hopes and that defense on. It was one EMP. Eco comes in, drops a big EMP, boom, that fight goes.
Illusion.
So
we get to see what they can accomplish.
Time starts getting quite low. Fusion have full, you know, C control. It's quite hard to push into, and then bam. Maybe they complete the entire, you know, defense on C, what remains of it.
It's the one way of Stoltzire Furious!
Disgustingly good arrow. Like you said, it might have just been bad RNG as well. Because he looked like he was aiming somewhere else. He was aiming at the player, just aiming at the entrance. And he hear a half.
More run of it!
I don't quite remember this, but the last time we were here for the Spaghetti Ball, the original one, for the Countdown Cup qualifiers, there was that creative sneak dart that was aimed towards. I believe Carpe
will be our downfall.
That reminds me of that same moment again. It happens to EQO again. God, that's so unlucky.
I mean, either way, absolutely incredible. And there's a game changer there. Not a mind not going to find some.
down, my lady. I shall be with you shortly.
You see, by the way, Sol's comp is very flexible. He's running with other kind of bases here. You're not going to run a fire into Ash Echo. You know, it's a composition where, you know, Nano's on Marvel. It's a good win condition.
Stay not ignorant. Remember to whom you speak.
Can go if they want to go shield. So, it's going to be a very similar comp in terms of the wins of dive. With Nidal Genji instead of
with an anti-aid. Slowing him up. Yes. Pitts continues to play on the low ground right here as
A. Choke the embers. Wind, blow out the flame.
The very nicely done. Positioning from him.
Hadoop. Pokes out. Tamarin.
Four alarm forces have finally to be used.
I'm just a messenger.
Sapa's going to be demeked. Fix there. Now without the damage mitigation. Ready to go. They just have to pull back and EQOs. Okay, yeah. Pitts is not going to be it. I have to swap this up.
Look at the difference in Alarm and Creator though. When Alarm got his nano boost, as they were losing the fight, if the Hopper dies, then just as he dies, Alarm gets the nano boost. So there's no way they were going to nano in that last fight. Creator was only about 50%, so Creator's caught up by another 30 now. Question will be, can Creator then gap the last 50% of the match, because this is going to be a Winston nano dive, and I'm not sure.
Bomber's
going to be available. That's a good hack as well.
Gets the hack on the Creator, but he play in a position to actually push too much damage in onto the enemy Ana. Almost gonna pop the primal rage and just get antied, but he's gonna be alright. He's still looking to knock them off the side of the map. He's chunked down to about half HP. Back down. Not quite. He managed to stay here on the side of the map. Zalbarrier now used. Funny Astro shielding up his team. Profit falling low. Goes for the dupe. Copies Mono. He's gonna be the first cast into you. And find that elimination. Headshot's good. Funny Astro's out of the fight. Hack on the mark doesn't find too much. Profit goes in. Now it's going to be a second primal range that they have to deal with. A second incident. This one leaps back out. Wait, this one though. A minute and a half remaining. The side of the Philadelphia Fusion is a dynasty. They very well could have back.
Tall enough to kick that ass.
Yeah, so you know anything could happen.
That's right.
I had to bring that up. I had to bring that up. It's spicy. Sol Dynasty. Profit is going to be under
position.
It's going to target and control Profit. Might actually say, Anima took no damage yet. The one member you have to kill is Creator, and that. He's just dominating QO. So now it's a 5v6. Nano's
that Procolon would be my home. Who would have thought?
Crucial pickup, a little bit of space, and now they can try to play in onto the point. To you, however. Disrupt, throws out the self-destruct. It's not going to be able to catch Funny Astro. He hides back by the Mega Pack, and the point is still being hit. The bomb down. Make his exit, self-destruct at the back.
The great Redania! From the mountains to the sea!
Again! Be able to get over there to try to bring him back into this fight. Seems like the answer's gonna be no. The corpse is just a little bit slower. Cannot get that Ana back in. Second tick now gonna be grabbed. You can see the Dynasty starting to play back. Go the full wave three. Allow this cap to come through because they know, you know what? We're still gonna have a time bank advantage. Pretty much no matter what the Fusion do from here on out.
Yeah,
see if they can hold him at B.
Every Fusion watch has had a combined sigh of relief. They're like, oh, thank God we got last day. We're going to move forward to B now as EQ has an EMP available. And taking down Fitz's Ash and Creator's Ana is you're not going to touch Profit. You can get those two, though. EMP.
Yeah, Bionade out into both supports, but either it's going to get Focus Fire.
Yeah! The human!
Goes in, Primal Rage pop.
Let's get this over with.
Get a corner onto somebody. Extra main targets. And at the end of it, he's managed to find Alarm before the ult expires. Akbar be demanded to supply and fix. So we'll pick up now. He's back behind the bus. Again, ready in case he needs to quickly keep himself safe.
That's a big pickup though. 5v6 now.
I don't know
why play the nano here. Creative's on very critical HP. He's down.
That's both supports now eliminated. Yeah, I mean, Marvel playing way too far forward. He was down to about half HP. I'm not sure why he was still trying to play in that position. We didn't have the leap, so couldn't get out to safety. But either way, those three kills mean that Fusion get point B.
Could have been miscommunication on Nano. Maybe Creative said he was close to it, and Marvel just assumed it was going to be there. Didn't come through, didn't happen. And now, we're over towards C, and look, okay, time-wise, obviously Fusion cannot match Sol Dynasty's 303. they can still cap above 1 minute. That has got to be the goal, because if you cap below 1 minute, we're looking at a draw. You can't wait until that. Nano's available for both sides. Yeah, Alarm's probably going to be used onto EQO.
Nano's out, Marvel's in. Moves up to zapping away, trying to get this next Primal online. Prophet goes out with a dupe. Copies Hot, but gets the D.Va. He's trying to get that self-destruct online, but it's a very slow build. He hasn't had the most impact when it comes down to this duplicate, so doesn't have that ready to go. Deadeye going to be insta-canceled there by Carpe.
Unless
it's been used for the reload, hard to say. But yeah, Fitz going to be eliminated, but he still holds on to the EMP for a final fight. Supercharger, however, slapped down. Mono looking to help escort them forward. Now Marvel's going to be dead. Can they even just contest this to you? Not going to get pulled off the cart here. Does manage to play forward, but somebody else has to get there. Fitz arrives. The EMP is going to hit five. But again, hooray, it means nothing. They finish the map. It's 2 minutes here in the time bank for the side of the fusion.
Second time today said that we've had the hooray EMP. The six-man comes through right at the end.
Both of them against the fusion.
Exactly. Both of us just like fusion being like, all right. As you needed to see Fitz drop this EMP early. He obviously got found on the high ground over around the second corner there. Soul Dynasty ran him through. Well, what did we have? We had EQO just teleporting into the high ground, running at Fitz. Doesn't care if the EMP goes on the high ground. Obviously, he then dies. If the EMP does not go into a fight for Soul as Fusion are pushing the payload, you're not going to find a good fight, because the end of that ended up being you lose Fitz and Prophet, your two most important players there, and then the rest of the Soul Dynasty are one by one slowly dying on the payload. Marvel did not have Primal. He was, I think, about 11% off, something in that range. TU then jumps on the payload, dies. Animo Creative jump on and die, and then Fitz does the hooray EMP to no avail as Philadelphia Fusion struggled on A. And now when I go back, you know, we go back to what I said and said, Fusion fans have got this collective sigh of relief, like, thank God we got past A. Like, yeah, thank God you got past A, because the rest of the maps are pretty easy. It was A that was the problem.
Yield and save me some time.
Just kind of rolled it from there. I mean, one mistake bleeds into multiple inside of the survivors. They can't find that stability ever again for that defense. So now we go into extra inning, starting things off the Fusion with their two-minute time bank. Let's see what they can get done. It's going to be EQO back on the Reaper. Carpe still going for some shooty-shooty bang-bang. Making their way around the left side as Alarm takes quite a bit of damage from Prophet Sticky Bombs.
Transferred over towards the zone of healing here for 32%. High ground being found. Mono chucked down. They've got to be careful about that.
You know, almost into beamable range there for Prophet. But speaking of Prophet, Carpe finds the elimination. Takes him down. The rest is before Marvel had fallen, might have been in a precarious spot, so maybe they would have put some back in the fight all the same, but they do find Alarm, but Creative now going to be traded out.
I'm an officer, I'm
down,
a gentleman.
Gets shot onto the baby D.Va. Mono will eliminate him. The cap nearly there for the side of the fusion, but it seems like it's going to take another attempt if they want to get this one locked down. The Soul Dynasty dude barely persevere.
I really like the adaptation from Fusion here, because you looked at the Fusion A attack previously and it wasn't going well. This time it's gone much better. They already have the win conditions are clear. The counters are there as well. The EQ are very important because they know that Marvel's off. They're trying to punish that dive. And finally, because Carpe's on a hit scan, they have some counter pressure versus Prophet's Echo as well. That was missing last time.
Right back into the fight. And Matrix going to be used as Carpe gets what it fits moments after he pulls Bob at the point. Yeah, Bob is not going to last very long at all. And that Ant Matrix set up on the high ground. Bob will be taken out. Just a moment.
I'm so dumb, kid. It's a pity I can never finish.
Carpe takes Robin out of the dupe and then instantly shuts down. And Anomaly Deadeye, absolutely massive, finishes off 2U with the flashbang. And that is the cap now on to A.
I never scored on stamina.
Have to stay glued to this card.
I think that's already been enough. Any distance they get on B now is going to be a bonus. Soul Dynasty has to really pull up this strategy. Stop this with whatever they can. It's just a self-destruct. They got
blueberries, blueberries. Lady of
resistance. And I think Philadelphia Fusion still have a bit of momentum behind them. Carpe's gone Widow for some reason. I don't know what he's expecting here. He has to know.
Best give up now.
Going to be an echo anymore, and he's even going to be a flanking Widow. Very interesting.
I mean, the Widowmaker, it feels like it's like his safety blanket. He feels at home with it, makes him calm. He goes for it. We'll see if this comes back to bite them in the rear or if it's going to pay off. Self-destruct going to be used. Doesn't find anything. They just go ahead and block it with a barrier. And answering self-destruct comes out. Everybody ducks inside. Now they're looking to play around the backside of this car. Here's EQ all on a bit of a flank angle. Jumping in, drops down. Take out EQ. Now they lose creative. There's no supports in the fight. Now they're losing out on their tank. And it was used on the Prophet. They push forward into point B. No one was contesting the card at all. Now Prophet is dead. And things are absolutely unraveling to the side of the Soul Dynasty.
Oh my god, they're just taking turns. Throwing and dropping the spaghetti ball. And now it's Soul's turn. They've just got it all over the floor. They can't do this defense anymore. Even if they win the defense now, two caps have been taking in the time bank. Okay, here we go. Hoppers back into Mancup. They still on the water for now to get that one kill to Animo like you mentioned, but I'm still questioning whether this is going to have long-term value.
Bob comes out. They deal with the Bob rather quickly, but Carpe going to be eliminated. EQL goes down. Everybody else as well. Seems like this should be the end of the line for the side of the Fusion, but this line was going so far back that you would have anticipated. Stop. A huge push from the side of the Fusion. For just starting with 2 minutes, they get the cap on A. When overtime is getting ready to come in, they never made it this far.
I would have been happy with Fusion just getting like a 98% on A. Maybe a cap that gets very quickly stopped. I think for most teams, that would be the expectation. But like, we've got 2 minutes to play with. Barney is very A defensive favorite anyway. So even capping the Barney A with the 2 minute time bank is. Can be quite rough, but they don't just get that. And this goes back to what we talked about earlier. A seems to be the problem. It's the other points that are fine. I mean, you get past A, and usually on the roll, B was pretty clean. They get it done. Cap comes through with no contest from Soul. They forgot about it. Maybe, you know, maybe they just got unlucky and somebody died and no one got the further touch. There were two folks.
Mind you, do like
whatever distance they got to see, like I mentioned, was just gonna be extra. It's bonus. B was already bonus. We're talking about double bonus. We got a lot of bonuses on the side of the Fusion. And Soul, oh my, they have got so much work to do.
I mean, yeah, that they do. It's not really a way to overstate.
Follow me!
Of the Dynasty right now. We scout forward. To get a read as far as what is being piled in. Oh, Marvel's getting apart. He's just gonna die. He's trying to go on the scouting mission, but they just shut him down.
Because he did the same thing as last time. And Fusion were like, all right, he's doing some scouting, cool. And now they know, all right, Marvel's probably doing the same thing. Let's just take him down.
Nice.
Stunned up, taken away. That's just a lot of HP being generated. Marvel goes over towards the Arrestor for the double shield call at the expense of a little bit of time lost and gain on the back end. By the time they actually get their, you know, push going, they've
been pushed down, eh?
Robert just trying to force Carpe's position.
The King and Country!
Stopping a state of again!
Gets up in front of their face. Considerable amount of damage is being pushed out. Prophet will find an opening kill. Funny Astro going to be the first one to fall. Mortality field used.
They say you are
going to be good for the blocks and sticky bombs, keeps himself safe for a bit longer. Carpe rounds the back, gets a great headshot instantly.
Tamara.
On to Carpe, beams down EQO, huge opening.
Lay down, my lady. I shall be with you.
Short line from the side. They have some staying power as they have made out of the lock as well. So they look to back out onto the point. They contest it. 0.3% left to go. Be point A going over to the side of this old dynasty. They've got a decent amount of time to play with here. A minute and 20 seconds before OT kicks in.
A lot of respect being shown there by the old dynasty as well. They've got the extra app matrix out of board for that fight to go awry. So 100% guarantee that they work on it. But I think there was maybe a bit of an argument to make where you could have held on to it. Obviously, the big argument to make for holding on to ults is you need to snowball
a witch's best friend is a pig! No doubt!
And the Philadelphia Fusion did. But they still can't afford to lose fights because they lose fights but instantly into the OT. They have one shot at this.
Need to get as much distance as we can here. Mortality field denies kills from the Flux. Quite a bit of damage pushed out on the fire. It seems like the Aster should be able to stabilize him. Rocket building up a fairly rapid flux as well. Dude's gonna be interrupted out of it, though. It's a final accretion stun on Tamano. Bonus pitch comes around the corner, finds Carpe, and EQO is gone. DPS duo eliminated as Fitz is just like an animal. Comes up with another kill on Alarm, but still time in the bank. The Dynasty will manage to make it into point B. 10 seconds to spare. Now they have to stay glued to this card. Is there any way to separate them from this?
Okay. Soul have to clutch up big time because they ran out of ultimates. They spent everything to get this beat cap. They didn't get it for free like Fusion did, and now Fusion have ult. They have four ultimates coming online. This is very heavily Fusion favored.
Long live the king!
It is right now because the map win is right ahead of you. You have so much to use here. Soul have nothing. Soul have to clutch big.
Huge amount of damage. Marvel is in desperate need of some assistance. EQO goes in, gets the duplicate out, takes down one. Reality Field now gone. Profit off. Somebody's got to touch the cart. They cannot make it there in time. The Philadelphia Fusion. Ooh, they give up so much distance. They manage to win it in OT. They take Nambani, their map pick. They will take a lead. 2-1 now in this series. Match point for them to punch their ticket into the playoffs. Just win one more.
Yep. Philadelphia Fusion, they got up from the table, went up for seconds there, loaded up their plane.
Long live
on the way back. Nearly tripped over, and then that plane floor, take it back to the table, and now to have their round number two. Second map on board there. The Soul Dynasty got it real close, man. Like, right up to the final push on towards C. So many things could have gone differently there, and I think if you're Soul right now, you got to look back at B and say, man, we need...
No. I don't near the ladder, they'd fall right out.
So, Delphi Fusion, match point now, a map away from making the playoffs.
The pressure mounting here from the side of the Soul Dynasty. Granted, they do have their map pick, but they absolutely need to make it count, much like we saw them do on Hanamura. We'll find out if they can do that. We'll find out what map we're going to when we come back from the break.
You're one sexy witch, and I'm here, please.
Don't go anywhere, guys. You do not want to miss this conclusion.
For Skellige's glory!
Patience is not a virtue I am known to have.
Alrighty, we are back. And oh boy, what a series this has been. Philadelphia Fusion making such an incredible run at the end of Nimbani in extra innings. Almost go to the end of the map in overtime. Seoul Dynasty so very close, yet still so very far from being able to best them. They end up losing on Fusion's map pick. Now they get one of their own as we get ready to go into Escort, but it's a must win for the side of the Seoul Dynasty if they want to extend this series and keep their hopes alive for going to the playoffs.
Now, look, I had a lot of faith that this was going to at least be a map 4. We're going to get the map 4 now. Question now becomes, can we get a map 5? Is there going to be a fifth map where we got to go the full distance or not? Shockwave comes in for EQO. So that's going to be another thing that has happened on the Fusion side of things. We have not so far had a Carpe substitution where he's out and Shockwave's in. That happened versus Spark. Here, Carpe's riding out. He's like, if I'm going up against Prophet, you're keeping me in the whole way. Carpe versus Prophet. One of the best like player versus player rivalries. Both players, I think Prophet was the first to hit 10K elims, but Carpe was second. The first two players in league history to hit 10,000 eliminations. And I believe still to date, the only two players to have gotten over 5,000 final blows. So, Fled is close. Probably. I think Fled is on like 4,900.
For Redania! For its glory! For king and country! Long live the king! For a great Redania! From the mountains to the sea!
So, I mean,
J-op!
Those 1v1s have been fantastic.
Yeah, I mean, they're two just absolute legends, and now there's, you know, one of the younger players that we have in Shockwave coming in alongside Carpe yet again, looking to take the victory here. I will go ahead and spoil it. The Seoul Dynasty, with their map pick of Escort, are taking us to Dorado, so not too shocking to see Carpe and Shockwave be the lineup here that they're deciding to go with. Double hit scan possibilities through the roof for Dorado, which is a map with some very long sight lines, so could just be seeing a lot of that come in.
I haven't seen Dorado in a long time. I'm trying to think about the last time Dorado was in the pool and we casted it. Melee? Maybe?
Yeah, maybe. It's been I don't know.
That's what it seems like to me. Because we've had Junkertown, Savannah's, Rialto's, all of that, but Dorado's getting back in the mix now. And I'm racking my brain trying to remember what was even planned. No, I think it was actually June Joust, because remember, Leave had that legitimate 6K on Echo, and I think that was during June Joust. So either way, it's been some time. And Dorado was a big map, obviously, for Echo, just brought that up. But you mentioned double hit scan can be an option here. Obviously, Shockwave coming in is a big proponent of that. Or it could just be like a Tracer Ash with Shockwave obviously on Ash, Carpe over towards the Tracer. That seems to be an option that Fusion have been running lately. I think when you bring in Shockwave though, my first instinct is to say that he's going to be either on like a Widow or an Ash, most likely an Ash.
Yeah, well, for the side of the Dynasty though, no changes to be had, so Jester's still going to be you know, absent. Seems like they've been having the most success with this. I mean, Marvel has been playing pretty damn well throughout the series so far. So it doesn't make sense to really change it up if it's on Shockwave. Shockwave will take his seat yet again as we get ready to hop into game. Fusion, a map win here. If they can just best the Dynasty on their map pick, they will push their ticket to the playoffs. That pressure
so close
can be a lot to try to cope with in the moment. So make sure to be showing, you know, showing some love for your respective team in the chat right now. Like, I don't know. I was trying to make a spaghetti reference with the Dynasty. I was going to say, like, grip this bowl to cheer for Seoul. I don't know. Just hope they don't drop the spaghetti.
Because you don't want to drop the bowl.
Exactly. So grip the bowl to cheer for Seoul. I don't really have as much. I don't think I'm on the hair.
There's plenty of spaghetti left to be served up. You better be ready. Get some space out there. A couple of burps out the way, you know. I think that give you like a 5-10 minute break. Just sit there.
A little bit harder to play that Genji. That'll be a halt.
Let's take a look at opening lineups in terms of comps. So you have Tracer Ash as expected for Philadelphia Fusion. Seoul Dynasty
probably play
waiting. Don't mind the Hanzo, that's for scouting purposes. As I mean, we'll just go over towards the sim anyway, so it doesn't even use Hanzo for scouting. I kind of hope to you doesn't play Zara. I had already my explanation of why I think that is in our last matchup. Also, I mean, if you remember the prior spaghetti ball that was in the Countdown Cup knockouts, you had this 2U versus Hotba kind of Zarya matchup, which Hotba won quite convincingly. But it does seem like Seoul now want to move through a double Bubbo. Echo is back in and on the menu also.
Well, Fitz is going to be forced to translocate fairly quickly there. Shockwave's Ash, so Prophet going to have to be very mindful of his positioning here.
Really make this tough fight. He's setting up for a
fairly long flank around that left side, but as the dive comes in, Marble going to get dropped. Alarm finds that opening kill, and Fitz has to try to exit. Shockwave still kills him.
That is a crazy flick from Shockwave. Just a 90-degree angle. Collects Fitz. Yeah. By the way, the read to even go downstairs to go for Fitz, and now gets Animo down as well. Shockwave's come in and really...
A little bit harder.
Shocking, and some waves shocking. Good cut away. I mean, Solo getting shocked currently. And it's not even Prophet getting taken down. Fitz has had no impact. He's just been bullied.
Start here for Sun and Dynasty, very much a polar opposite from what we were seeing on Numbani. They were able to just storm into point A. That cap, getting the cart moving right now, proving to be a bit difficult. Marvel just going for these short little leaps, trying to get that primal rage up, barely makes an exit. Creative surges up, nearly with that nano available, now has it. Can use that for an engage to try to get them off this high ground, but there's so much staying power for the fusion.
This payload positioning is really awful for Sun as well. They just barely been able to do anything with that. They're pushing up now. Marble finding us a nano.
Doesn't manage to find anything to you. Barely stays alive. We'll come up with two. Along with Shockwave, both going to be eliminated. In the back, Primal Rage jumps up. And he is just sending Bono sailing across the map. Get the eliminations. That's going to be an effective team wipe here. Arpe is the last one standing at the cart. We'll get finished off in the end. The cart can finally start moving forward.
Corporations are people too.
I pass on every 10th round.
Who spilled my ink? Confessor be damned!
Long live, etc., etc.
Their foul magicry!
Same and upgrade of a combo will be getting picked off. Carpe coming up with two. Still low at HP, but he wants to get rid of it.
Gentlemen, mount up! Yes, you! Have you made your offering?
How do you play this grab right now? You need a force from... Any of ours have died of late.
That one! He venerates not the fire!
Bloody wind. Sever it, my...
Ever faithful, the Flaming Rose. Sword of the Order! Flaming Rose!
Yeah. 10 seconds off the clock for Sol Dynasty, just to wait for that.
You! Have you made your offering?
Get thee behind me!
Neither of mercy nor forgiveness. You, yes, you! Have you made your offering?
Situated on the high ground, perhaps. An alarm already fighting creative.
Now just I think the just having this.
Rejoining creative, you gotta get through this. Prophet falling low, will get top back up, but Anamo is dead. Marvel is dead. Shockwave gonna be the only casualty thus far. The cart starting to roll. Carpe sits there, lobbing arrows at people. Won't find
obviously. A little bit harder to play that Genji. That'll be a halt with the Amp Matrix drop.
High ground control. This was something that was completely missing on Soul.
Matrix drop down.
Never had this high ground control.
Down there.
Never had a free
Matrix drop down there.
It's been unimpeded. It's been rolling through the entire time.
Drop down there.
Very successful. It's already in the
down there. That.
If it's coming back over.
Matrix drop down there.
See if this works. It is a favorable match.
Down there.
Carpe and Shockwave. Superior
and that'll force out
get past.
Matrix drop down there.
That's the question.
Playing indoors right now. Barrier going to be set up on the one entrance. Hold them together.
And that'll force out the Primal Rage.
Yeah, you're ready to fight.
Okay. This now needs to try to get on some kind of flank angle, but I don't know. We'll find one.
Press those vermin!
Coming through the ball, offer has anything to respond with now. It will be hot. This turn, creative, the window down. It's the
gets away with that one, but a hot.
About half-assed self-proclaimed authority.
Mary, that's what matters.
Seems like almost an impossible task here for the side of the dynasty. The doors open, the cart will start advancing yet again. The Philadelphia Fusion have been licking their lips the prospect of this playoffs appearance that is right before them.
So I feel like seeing busted out soon.
A little bit harder to play that Genji. That'll be a halt with the Amp Matrix drop down there.
Yeah, you really think Harvey gets away with that one, but a halt drags him back into the purview of the application matrix. Yeah, you really think Harvey gets away with that one, but a halt drags him back into the purview of the application. Yeah,
you
really think
Harvey
gets away with that one, but a halt.
Well,
gets away with that one, but
not going to last, nor will any other member from the side of the dynasty. That
gets away with that one, but
will push it through. They manage to make it happen here on Dorada, on the dynasty's final.
From longer ranges, start to build that blade up before you have the opportunity. So Felix seeing busted out soon.
A halt with the Amp Matrix drop down there.
Yeah, you really
fight
think Harvey
well.
Gets away with that one?
No horse, I said. Wanted the exercise, I said.
I'm an officer and a gentleman.
Don't retreat! Damn it!
Long live Exodus.
Never mind.
I
your spear, sir.
Give them 2 days before they cower in the streets.
I pass on every 10th rise.
A coat of arms is nothing you choose. Dare not mock mine.
Get thee behind me.
Gladly help, if I live to see it.
Mary, that's what matters.
For king and country!
Feeling a bit of deja vu.
Or mace, sir.
Long sword, back sword, army sword, bastard sword.
Series looking scarier, I think, than they have throughout this entire season. And that's with
from longer range. Start to build that lineup before he has the opportunity
to
go. So I feel like seeing busted out soon. I'm
sure how that was going to go.
Makes it obviously a little bit harder to fight that Genji. That'll be a halt with the Ant Matrix drop down there. Yeah, you really think Harvey gets away with that one?
Yeah, I mean, it's taken a while, but this
drop down there. Matrix drop down there. Yeah, you're really fighting.
Solar bested, Solar not going to go to the playoffs. I'm sure that's going to be a disappointing end. I think
just drop down. Yeah, you really think Harvey gets away with that one?
Overall,
with the Ant Matrix drop down. Yeah,
you
really think Harvey gets
playoffs as well? It's a bit of a sad point going from grand finals the previous year to this now, where unfortunately they're not going to go to the playoffs at all. But them's a break sometimes. There's only room for one more team.
Drop down. Yeah, you really think Harvey gets away with
that? Also marks the end of the 8-pack broadcast for 2021. This was the final one, ladies and gentlemen out there, as all future matches after this will be, you know, obviously there's one more play-ins broadcast for North America.
Down. Yeah, you really think Harvey
over towards all
strap down.
Yeah,
you really think Harvey gets away with that one?
Taken over on that
with the Ant Matrix drop down.
Yeah,
you really think Harvey gets away with that one?
Thank you for allowing me to be your partner.
No problem, man. It's been an absolute pleasure to have you alongside me this whole way through. Granted, I had to fill in. My heart was always with you in this duo. It's been a wonderful first season, I think. I hope that a lot, people enjoyed our commentary throughout this run of it. You know, I think we were able to get things off the ground pretty quickly, and I'm very happy with the end result of it all. But unfortunately, yep. That is the end of the line for us. So for now, we'll be joining you guys in the spectator seats, watching the action unfold in, you know, the rest of the play-ins, in the playoffs, to see who is going to be crowned the champion here at the end of the season. But something tells me that this isn't goodbye forever. It's just temporary.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
We'll see you guys hopefully again in 2022 with the next season. But until then, thank you so much for tuning into the APAC broadcast the whole way through. You guys are the realest fans there are out there. We love all of you. We'll see you next time.
Overwatch 2, baby!
Woo! From longer ranges, start to build that lane up before you have the
opportunity.
So feel like seeing busted out soon, I'm sure. From longer ranges, start. Start to build that plane up before you. From longer ranges. Start to build that plane up before you have the opportunity. So feel like seeing busted out soon, I'm sure.
Genji, that'll be a halt with the Ant Matrix dropped down.
Yeah, you really think Harvey gets away with that one? Yeah, you really think Harvey gets away with that one?
That'll be a halt with the Ant Matrix drop down.
Yeah, you really think Harvey gets away with that one? Longer ranges. Start to build that plane up before you have the opportunity. So feel like seeing busted out soon, I'm
sure. A little bit harder to play that Genji. That'll be a halt with the Ant Matrix drop down.
Yeah, you really think Harvey gets away with that one?
Nice kill to Eileen, though.
Yeah, just kind of lobbing that one through. That maybe Eileen was going to be able to evade that, but it seems like he didn't have the leap available. That said, on the back end, three kills come in as Griff finds two of them. Mondu will get it out, but now with Bernard falling, Architect having used the recall already, and Gujue
under the
so feel like seeing busted out soon, I'm sure. So it's a nice intro.
A little bit harder to play that Genji. That'll be a halt with the Ant Matrix drop down.
Yeah, you really think Harvey gets away with that one?
Blows himself just out of it. A lot more ultimates online now for the Rocket Charge. It's another situation behind.
Not all battles need end in bloodshed.
Give them 2 days before they cower in the streets.
I pass on every 10th round.
Gladly help. If I live to see it.
Mary, that's what matters.
For king and country!
Axe or mace,
Overwatch League is brought to you by TeamSpeak, the official voice supplier of the Overwatch League.
Onward!
Run, he's nano boost, he's got
hunters, they want 0 run. Valiant, you gotta do it. At least one map in the series. We're gonna jump.
that up.
Stamina!
Snooze it away, still just pumping with the damage. Storm arrows come in. Griv.
Death holds no surprises.
The back line of the team. It's a couple of head taps there on the Gushway. Sets up for the rest of the pile and get the elimination. And that'll be the end of this initial attack.
Follow me!
Long live Eccentrics.
Shy manages to find Karib with the Dragon Strike crashing in. They're now onto the point and breaking them off. This is going to prove to be a very difficult situation.
Or mice.
The only good dwarf is a dead dwarf.
From the mountains to the sea!
You want a piece of Bronwyn and Scruffy? Well?
Double face!
on every 10th round.
I'm in no mood for jests.
Down, my lady. I shall be with you shortly.
I
haven't been able to check because I haven't seen his player cam in a while, but if that doesn't wake you up in the morning, I don't know what will. It will still be a 109 time back, not as flashy, not as pretty, good looking as that 250, but it's workable. And for Guangzhou Charge, I think because we're realistically only going to be playing for the A point anyway, and they had a really convincing A point, Rio going back over towards the Orisa, if they can manage to make their way onto the point with minimal obstruction, minimal interruption coming through from the Hangzhou Spark, which is actually a bit of a mistake from the Spark, I think. They didn't really intercept or try and slow down or force a fight mid-rotation from the Charge. If Charge just get onto the point and Kareev drops a window, A is kind of done. It's going to be tough.
Yeah. Well, here we go. Extra innings now. Guangzhou first on the attack. Just over a minute to try to make this happen. TP forward. Just over to the side. Looting any potential stray headshots that Shy could be throwing at them. As well as Coldest, I suppose, charging up those right clicks.
A lot of this is going to, for me, come down to Architect, actually, because if he gets another really fast pulse bomb, when Guangzhou Charge want to bunker up, that's when a pulse bomb can find an easy target. If they can get it picked that way, that would be brilliant.
Good straight playing it safe. Pile drives up top, and oh god, Shy, he's already getting it going. Finds Kariv. Little headshot choice. They want trying to harass him as best as possible. Shot not quite going to connect. A little more to the right. Maybe he would have been able to have it. Either way, they just have to just sit back.
That's
wait
half
for
the
response.
Time gone.
Yep.
Charge have to reset. They're down to below 30 seconds. Not only that, look at Kareev's ult charge. He's so far behind because he's the one dead. They're not going to get a fast window. So not only did they not get a fast window, but then also Spark might get an ult before Kareev, which would be absolutely amazing for the Spark.
Couple members getting taken down to about half HP. Bernard's still going to be hovering around there. Slowly gets top back up. Protect under some fire. There's the charge finally. Set foot here on the point. Bubbles out in the Gooseway. Goes in with the pile driver. Gets that slight little knock up. They're looking for Shy, but they cannot finish him off. That, however, flashbang from Eileen gets the killing blow onto Bernard. Gooseway taken low. Everybody's zoned back, so two ticks at least going to be picked up here for the side of the charge. Do they get the full cap? Somebody's going to have to contest here pretty soon.
There's no ticks.
Gooseway now going to fall. Dragon Strike comes through, but it's not going to find anything. Everybody just splits away from it. Now Shy is going to be gone. Mika eliminated. Architect tries to go in. Recall already going to be burned. The whip shot will finish him off, and it's 30 seconds added back to the clock now. Not too much to try to snowball this with, but the rally and pulse bomb might just be enough for an extended fight.
I mean, I don't even know that they need to go to get a take care charge. Would love any sort of bonus distance. Anything they get on B is going to be a bonus because getting A is the prime target. Because they've got an A, the defense for the time back should be pretty solid now. Spark can hold this. They have Transcendence. They have more ults coming online. Minefield as well. Charge would have to play this excellently and maybe find another window to actually get a cap here.
All right, we'll force out the OT. Choice A1. Now going to be scouted. Strong. Devours Architect's Pulse Bomb. That's going to be a huge opening. It's Jose Juan still on the hunt. Hasn't yet selected his target. Shy's going to be picked off, but Eileen will die before he can get a dead eye rolling. OT starting to bleed away. They touch back onto the point yet again. Jose Juan trying to bide his time, trying to pick his moment very carefully here. Doesn't want to have this Pulse Bomb get eaten. He sees Coldest now. Rally armor rolling, keeping him topped up. Volt support's going to be gone for the side of the charge. It seems like maybe it's going to be a Far Cry dream to get that single tick on point B. As everybody else will continue to fall down, the Pulse Bomb got nothing. The Deadeye will just go ahead, bleed away as we get ready to go into the next half. But it's a solid play here for the side of the charge, given that they had just a minute and 9 seconds. And I mean, yep. If they give up point A, we very well could be looking at a draw as well.
You said they have a minute and 9 seconds, but really they had 20 seconds because they lost Kareev straight away in that first fight. By the time they actually made a move, they might as well have had only 20 to 25 seconds, and within that time, with Kareev starting on something like 35% ult charge, if you looked at a specific ult charge rate, he instantly got that window in record time. I did not expect that. I didn't know his healing was going to be that good. I mean, it is AoE, and you are taking a bit of a peppering of damage from the Hangzhou Spark, but it's not like Hangzhou are playing the Pharah here, so you're not just getting splashed from above. And still, bunker up on the point. Window gets dropped down. That's the win condition, and it is so hard for the Hangzhou Spark to actually challenge that setup when they do not have ultimates. You saw that Shy was maybe just a couple percentage points off. He was very close to that Dragon Strike, and if he had it just slightly early, and this is even with the kill to Kareev, that's why it's so impressive that Kareev gets this, but also the fact that Spark are always just slightly off in terms of the damage to just get that ultimate to do something about it. Maybe look at Architect as well. Pulse Bomb can really stop that, but if you don't have the tools, Kareev's window, that Amp Matrix from Charge, once that happens on A, the A cap might just be gone.
Well, moving forward, Shy, I mean, that initial headshot to open things up last time, the charge cannot afford to have that happen again. They need to play around his sightlines very intelligently. Right now, everybody going to be tucked away inside the garage, aside from Gushue and Architect, to go on a bit of a flanking mission. Scouting Arrow, finding quite a many few targets. That first shot, narrowly avoiding Eileen. He'll get a couple extra into him, but he manages to survive, at least for now. Recall going to be forced down. Gushue getting stunned up. Coldest eliminated. Good flashbang. Able to pump some extra damage into Bernard, but Architect will take out Eileen. Now Mandu going to be falling. Architect manages to find two. That leaves just Kariv as a solo healer now for the side of the charge, and everybody's still clustered together. Gushue going to be eliminated, though, and it seems like the TPS 204, the Spark, will die as well. They do get picked off. They'd love to get Bernard D-Mech to force him to jump off the map. That's not quite going to happen, but a minute and 45 seconds now remaining. Guangzhou charge, it's a very solid start for them as the rest of the team rejoins.
Absolutely. I mean, look, Mandu dies, but Kariv living there, A, means he's going to have an Atmetrix now, but also he may be a solo healer, but Spark had no healer because Mika and Coldest both died. Here we go. Let's see what this window can do for them.
Matrix is keeping everybody contained. They can't advance forward through it, so they have to just respect it. Stun comes in. I think he actually might have lost that pulse bomb. Architect responds with one of his own. Doesn't manage to find anything. Dragon Strike goes out. Just gets a little bit of damage dealt, but overall, not too much. Choice A1 with no recall down to 4 HP, desperately crying out for some heals. He does receive it. Spark out-rotating them just a bit. They manage to get the inside tracked over onto the point. The first tick is getting ready to come through. The charge now have to try to re-aggress and retake this. Multiple ultimates to work with, but can they utilize them properly? We're about to find out right now. Self-destruct going to be thrown into the back by Bernard. He looks for a pick. He managed to find Eileen as well as the supercharger, and then Rio goes down off the back end of that. Kariv dead to the mines. Mandu with a rally rolling. Now is going to be wishing that he held onto it to try to force a draw, because the Spark are going to be capping point B. They are going to be getting 30 more seconds added to this time bank, and the charge now, if they don't want this to get tied up 1-1, need to play this out and deny a tick away.
There is a high possibility of a draw. I do have to say that, but the reason and the way that Spark can actually maybe get past this is they have a Dragon Strike nearly online, Transcendence as well. They can survive up against Sand Matrix. In fact, they probably should. When Kariv drops this down, and he's going to probably wait until he really has to, when Spark want to commit, because you don't want to drop it too early like he did on towards A, that's when Trance and Dragon Strike need to come on through, and you need to play in towards the Sand Matrix to make sure Kariv doesn't get value.
Okay, he throws a Dragon Strike over towards left spawn door. Deadeye gets the cancel there from Eileen. Not looking to stay in a precarious spot. 20 seconds about to be remaining on the clock.
They gotta wait it out.
Yeah, Choice A1. Pulse bomb needs to be big from him if they want to pull this off. Gushue, however, under fire. He barely manages to roll out, grabs both mega packs to stay alive. Self-destruct into the back from Krong, not going to find a pick, but it will force the Transcendence out. Choice A1, he finds the most crucial target that he possibly could. It's Shy, eliminated at the ultimate. Eileen going to be jumped on, however, Coldest will find the headshot kill. OT going to be forced out. Spark still very well have a fighting chance in this right now. Coldest comes up with yet another one. Mandu going to be eliminated. Kariv under fire. Gushue dives in. Rio discorded out. He will be eliminated. Choice A1 has finally gotten rid of the Zenyatta, but now the rally armor is getting pushed out from Mika to try to give them some staying power here on point B. Rio going to go down. Krong going to be de-mecked. And it seems like the Spark might just be able to clutch this out from the jaws of a draw at the very end. They will manage to make it happen with the OT. And Hangzhou Spark will tie up this series 1-1. If you're the Guangzhou Charge, that is it. You cannot give them any more map wins.
That's the last one. This is going to go to at least four maps regardless. Now it is kind of do or die for the Guangzhou Charge. This season quite literally is going to rest upon their next two maps, and maybe even just the next map. If Spark takes it, it's done. There's no more score lines that can save them. And this was a very close map. This was a situation that maybe could have ended in a draw, but I think twice now, once on A especially, you saw that initial window placement from Kariv. Spark just hide away. They don't have to play into that one. They go into the side room, they wait it out, and they come back through. And you see the difference it makes, by the way, when Spark have ultimates and I can actually play into the bunker, it makes a world of difference. Okay, Rio wants to drop a supercharger. The response is burn our self-destructs in, and suddenly Spark are back into the game. There's another window coming down towards B. Now, there was a lot more patience shown to that one, but still just enough time remaining for the Spark to once again wait it out, do not play into it, and then actually come back through earlier. If they still had the Dragon Strike, maybe they could just, like, dive directly into it. But without the Dragon Strike, Kashai used it. They decided to wait, and well, the patience was rewarded. They had the Transcendence, then the rally coming up towards the end, and Spark finished the cap.
Wow, no more breathing room available for the side of the Guangzhou Charge. Another map dropped, and whether or not they win this series or not, it doesn't matter. Their season will be over, so need to win out two consecutive maps from here to take this with that 3-1 scoreline. We'll see if they can make it happen or if the Spark can prove to be an upset squad yet again when we come back from the break.
The Overwatch League is brought to you by TeamSpeak, the official voice supplier of the Overwatch League.
Alrighty, we are back, and the Guangzhou Charge have their backs up against the wall right now. One more map loss, and that is going to be their season in, I was going to say in the dumpster, but that's just their season kind of going kaput for them. They still can win this series 3-2, but unfortunately that won't be good enough. Hangzhou Spark taking Volskaya is just about the worst thing that could have happened here for the Guangzhou Charge. Now they need to win two straight maps to be able to make it into this next cup. And then potentially have a run through the play-in. So pressure is absolutely mounting for them, and it just seems like for the Hangzhou Spark, Spark, despite his webcam issues, Shy, he is nothing but, you know, if not awake right now. The guy is absolutely popping.
Yeah, it's a sleeper pick with Woker gameplay, as I think what we're seeing there is still really pumping out tons of damage. I think on that defense for B as well, was getting something like one Dragon Strike per fight. Even some of the fights were slower to start, so we'll give him that in terms of a bit of a caveat. But otherwise, I mean, the ultimates were coming on very consistently. Have to say, it was a good roll through on the attack to get B, because it was nearly a draw. That could have been a draw. Very close to being a draw. But they played patiently when they needed to, and they were able to get ultimates and strike when they needed to as well to make sure they could get that cap. If it was a draw, I think Guangzhou would be breathing a bit of a sigh of relief. I mean, you say it's the worst thing that could have happened.
the gentleman.
You'll regret your mum ever squirting you out. My coins rang to you. Go kiss a dog neath its tail.
We ride into the fray.
Just a message. I've seen it already.
Only the valley we're here to do that.
see victory for you. The Wilds shall reclaim your fields.
Let's give up now!
Business for me.
It's not about why, it's about why not.
Too fast for you, Dwan. Special prize, just for you, love.
For king and country!
Dressed up, stuck in the stirrups again!
Get this over with.